feels perfect. Other days it just ain't working. The good, the bad, the right, the wrong, and everything in between. Yo, it's crazy, amazing. We can turn our heart through the words we say. Mountains crumble with every syllable. Hope can live or die. So speak life.
Welcome to the House of Prayer Live Radio Ministry. You've got Sister Angie here, Evangelist Willie Grizzle, better half. If you would like to call in your prayers, call 270-681-8098. Or you, if you'd like, you can call him on his cell, 270-943-8429. Stay tuned and God bless and keep praying.
It's like I'm drowning in the deep. Well, it's crazy to imagine words from my lips as the arms of compassion. Mountains crumble with every syllable. Hope can live or die. So speak life to the deadest, darkest night. Speak life when the sun won't shine and you don't know why. Look into the eyes of the brokenhearted. Watch them come alive as soon as you speak. Fire, hope will fall like rain when you speak life with the words you say. Raise your thoughts a little higher, use your words to inspire. Joy will fall like rain when you speak life with the things you say. Lift your head a little higher, spread the love like fire. Hope will fall like rain when you speak life with the words you say. So speak.
Praise the Lord, everybody. This is yours truly, the evangelist, Willie Grizzle from Scottsville, Kentucky, down here in Allen County. Amen. Praise God. I hope today that you're doing fine. I hope you're inspired. But you know, today we're going to talk about you must die to live. Praise God. See, my friends, when we come into this world, amen, we are sinners. But you know, there's a choice. There's a map that God gives us that we must do. We must be like an old wheat that dies, goes into the ground, amen, where we could be fruitful. But you know, my friend, you got to let this old man down, amen. You got to let this world go by, praise God, because this world is not our home. The home to come is that New Jerusalem. You know, like I said back in Revelations, about John said he's seeing a New Jerusalem coming down, praise God. So my friends, are you ready for that new, or are you trying to make heaven on earth? See, my friends, today we need to be proclaiming the word of God. Everywhere we go, it doesn't matter if we're at work or if we're at a church or if we're at Walmart or if we're at a gas station. If you see an opportunity to open your mouth to talk about Jesus, hey, let it go. See, the word of God says, in the hour you to speak, he will fill your mouth. So, my friends, that's what we're doing this hour today, is filling our mouth with the Holy Ghost to help you. Praise God, to help you get on the track in the glory of God. Amen. So my friends and my family, we got some call-ins, praise God, from Brother Boyd. Amen. So if you'd like to call in, remember to call, hold on. Praise God. Got my number covered here. Amen. There we go. All right. That number is 270-681-8098. 8098. Hey, pass that number around. Let everybody know that the House of Prayer Radio Ministry here, we pray for all things, big or small. Amen. See, God can use the smallest thing to make big miracles. Amen. So, my friends and family, remember, call that number, 270-681-8098. And remember to pray for Bishop Eddie Chaney. Praise God. Before we go to that, I got it over here on Facebook. He's hard at work. It looks like that he's mowing the yard and getting ready to set up a tent for Friday down there in Myrtle County. Well, the video will explain it. It starts at 7 o'clock. So, brothers and sisters, let's listen to this video from Bishop Eddie Chaney. He's down there in Eastern Kentucky. Amen.
Praise God. We got us some volunteers this morning. Brother Terry come over. He's going to help us a little bit here with the tent site. You guys can see we're gaining ground. Amen. Got Tony going to help today. We got the fire burning, coming around the building. The tent will actually be right there where Tony's walking. Right out back on the dry hump in case it rains more. Praise God, guys. Look over how we look. We're on it this morning. Praise God. We still got some more grass. We're cutting up here around the building things. We've got Brother Donnie on the hole this morning. He's going to hold the beans. We're just getting it all took care of. Anybody want to help, come on out. Amen. At least take a little moment and drop us off a prayer. Amen. For strength and wisdom to get all this done. By tomorrow evening, we're going to start putting the tent up. That'll be Friday. Tomorrow. You want to help? Come on by. Right here, Knott County, Kentucky. Where we at, Brother Donnie, actually?
Malley.
Where at?
Malley.
Malley. Right here in Malley. Above Hyman or Hayman or whatever. Hyman.
6 miles out of Hyman.
6 miles out of Hyman. Up here at Brother Donnie Sloan's. Sister Sandra's, come on by if you want to get a free bologna sandwich and cut a few weeds. Amen. God bless, guys. Thank you for your prayers. Amen.
Amen. Praise God. That's Bishop Eddie, hard at work, praise God. They're cleaning out the area. It looks like they're doing a pretty good job. So everybody, please remember Bishop Eddie Chain and the Sons of Thunder, if I ain't mistaken. I don't know if Evangelist Chris Chaney has saved an American soul one soul at times down there, but if he is, remember him in prayer. There's a mighty move of God going on down there. Like it says, Miley, Kentucky, down about 6 miles back from Henderson. I think that's how it's pronounced. That's pretty bad. It's my hometown. I can't even remember it. Praise God. Only thing I can remember is Blue Diamond. That was the town that I was raised in. Praise God. But you know, time and change and memories fail. Amen. But you know, God never fails. When it comes down to the things we need to remember, God will restore our memory, amen, and bring it to remembrance. Praise God. So, brothers and sisters, like I said, I got a couple call-ins from Brother Boyd. I hope you enjoy. And remember, call in at 270-681-8098. And give inspirement to someone out there today that's caught up in a sin or alcohol or fornication or whatever it is that's hindering them from coming to the truth of the Lord Jesus Christ, that they need to get away from it and die and where they can live. See, my friends, I ain't talking about a living like a physical. I'm talking about spiritual living. See, we walk through the spirit, not of the flesh or the eyesight, my friends. So, brothers and sisters, it's time you to listen from this man of God down here in Idaho. Praise God that he's called in. He's a faithful caller in, a Brother Boyd London. If you'd like to help Brother Boyd London, hey, hit him up on Facebook there. I don't know if he's Facebook's activated, but you could contact his sister, Ann. All you got to do is click on my friends list, look under Boyd or Ann, and they'll help you out in any way you can. See, we both to help each other out, no matter if we fight among each other, praise God. And I'm not saying me and Brother Boyd's fighting, but I'm just saying that I have had conversations and we have bumped heads with brothers and sisters, amen. But, you know, we got to love them, because What are we both to do, my friends? We both to pray for one another, love one another, love the hell right out of them. Amen? So, brothers and sisters, let's listen to this testimony from Brother Boyd.
Hello, Brother Willie. I love you, and I'm praying for you. God bless you. This is Brother Boyd London in Idaho. I have three words spoken by Jesus for us to really think over. These are powerful words that can save, change your eternal destiny and save you also. Repent or perish. Repent or perish. Repent or perish. That's what Jesus said. We've got to repent. If we don't repent of our sins, we will perish. Many people go to church on Sundays and believe in Jesus, say they're saved by John 3:16, saved by grace. Don't talk to me about my sin because we're covered by grace. And they live in pornography, homosexuality, drug abuse, drunkenness, bisexuality. They're fornicating with their boyfriends and girlfriends before marriage, saying they go to church and they believe in Jesus. And God and Jesus are going to pat them on the back and they're going to walk right into heaven. But if you truly look at the scriptures, Jesus said, repent or perish. You got to repent and get the porn, the pornification, drug use, drunkenness, homosexuality, lying, cheating, cussing, cursing, foul language, all those sins out of your life, or you can't go where Jesus is. You can read it at the ending of Revelation, nothing impure. Those who don't do it, shameful or deceitful, all liars, the cowardly, the unbelieving, they will go to the fiery lake of burning sulfur. This is the second death. Repent or perish, Jesus said. Jesus says, if your hand causes you to sin, cut it off. If your eye causes you to sin, pluck it out, for it's better in your life maimed than to go into the eternal fire that is never quenched. And Jesus was radical about sin. If you have a computer that's causing you to watch porn and things like that, you better give it to somebody else for a while and get it out of your place so you're not looking at it. If you're going after worldly possessions and being rich towards the world and not towards God and seeking after women, all that kind of stuff, you need to change your lifestyle and repent and get those things out of your life and be radical and truly turn your heart and life over to Jesus and to his purposes. Now, another type of sin is James 4:17. Anyone who knows to do good and doesn't do it is living in sin. Matthew chapter 7 says, Jesus says, many are going to say, Lord, Lord, but not have done the will of God, are going to be cast out. And if you're not doing the will of God and putting Jesus' words into practice and just believing in him and not being a doer of the word, you have a dead faith, and that can all, you can also get cast out because you're not doing the will of God. Jesus says to take up our cross, deny ourselves daily, lose our life for him and the gospel. We're supposed to go preach the gospel to all creation, make disciples of all nations, teach them to obey everything and baptize them. That's a great commission. We're supposed to help orphans and widows. James 1:27, people in the prisons and hospitals, anyone in need, the parable of the sheep and the goats. We're supposed to pray without ceasing. 1 Thessalonians 5, 16-18, we're supposed to lay down our lives for Jesus, preaching to others, praying for others, helping needy people, helping orphans and widows, helping people in the prisons, hospitals, and nursing homes, laying down our life for the gospel. That's doing the will of God. And if you're hard-hearted and don't do the will of God, you can be cast out. The goats in the parable of sheep and the goats never helped anyone. The goats never helped anyone, and they get cast into hell. So we got to be doers of the word. We got to repent. God bless all.
Abraham prayed for the day God would give him a son. Blessed Isaac was his name, the greatest gift he'd ever known. Then came the day, who would have dreamed God would say, give him to me. On this mountain you will prove it's you and Isaac, or it's me and you. When I lay broken heart, but my father's proud, on this altar here he lays, justified, it wasn't him, he wanted me. Most of us, I dare to say, haven't I in God's way. out your eyes that he wants, he's wanting you. When I lay my eyes in there, broken heart, but my father's proud. On this altar here he lay, just to find it wasn't him God wanted me. On the altar here he lay, just to find it wasn't him God wanted me.
Amen, amen. You know, there's so many people in church today that needs to lay down their Isaiah. If it's their grandkids or their children or their drug habits, their fornication, their porn, whatever it is, lay it down, my friend. Because you're not going to get into heaven with sin in your life. Brother Boyd, he just brought that up, didn't he? See, you got to be purified of this world. And you know, today the Lord, he's bringing it to my heart that we need to be talking about what is purification. Amen. See, to be purified, something's got to die. Amen. Something's got to be made clean. Something's got to be growing inside of you. And I ain't talking about a fungus either. I'm talking about the Word of God. See, a lot of people today get caught up in religion. Amen. They're not caught up in the will of the Father. They're caught up in religion. They want to repeat something that they did 20 years ago or talk about things they done 20 years ago. See, my friends, today you got an opportunity to make the Word of God apply to your heart. And you can be, amen, praise God, you could be a story of the Bible. Amen. See, my friends, you're a walking example why Jesus Christ died. That's right. He died on that old rugged cross that you could be free from your sins, your disease, all of your depression, your anger, your strife, your backbiting, your backsliding, all that stuff. It can come to the halt if you'll come to the truth of God. You know, like Isaiah, he was tied and binded, amen? And you can imagine what that little boy was thinking when Abraham had to put him up on there and draw that blade, fixing to take his life. But God says, now I know who you truly serve. See, my friend, sometimes you got to walk that path. Amen. You got to go, you're going to have to do things that people think you're crazy for doing. But see, there's a lot of people thought Jesus was crazy too. Now think about this. There's a lot of times that Jesus come up and he stood right in the face of the Pharisees and said, hey, I'm here to do the Father's business. You ain't going to like me in the long run. And they didn't. Now think about it. The Pharisees had the people, got them all churned up, praise God, and to have him crucified. See, but Jesus didn't want to die. Because it says in the scriptures that he said, Lord, if it be your will, take this cup from me, but let your will be done. See, we got an opportunity right now to take a hold of that cup, praise God, and drink from it. And to do God's will on this earth, and as we walk and talk and do God's will, why ain't we speaking about Jesus Christ? You know why? Because a lot of people won't. When they hear the name of Jesus Christ, they think of worldly religion. See, I serve a mighty God. Praise God. I serve a God that can heal me when I'm sick. He can fix me when I'm broken. And he can fill my mouth when I ain't got nothing to say. Amen. See, my friends, that's what we got to die daily. See, we got to pick up our cross every day. We all got crosses. We all got baggage. Amen. But you know, let me tell you something. There is something you can do about it. You can put it on that old altar today. Amen. That you could give your life to Jesus Christ. Don't think about the world of religion. Don't think about wearing a suit and tie. Don't worry about the things that people talk about you and gossip. Hey, don't worry about that. See, they won't be the one you'll have to answer to when you lay down this walk of life. See, Jesus Christ said, I am the Alpha, the Omega, the first and the last. And he is the one that causes, he is the one that does the judgment. So why do we worry about what other people think? I'll tell you why people do that. Because everybody wants to be somebody. I'm a nobody. I'm dirt. Amen. But you know, God saved my soul that I would be able to get up here where you could hear this old hillbilly preach the word. See, now if you had asked me 10 years ago if I'd been behind a mic preaching or been in a church preaching, I'd probably looked at you and said you're crazy. But you know how time goes? That God deals with us every second of our life. Praise God. That when we think we're alone, we're not. Because he's always there. See, the Holy Ghost, he said in his own word, as I go away, where the Holy Ghost can come and comfort you. See, we got to take the word of God for what it says and obey it to the fullest of our knowledge. Amen. See, my friends, because one day we're going to lay down this walk of life. And what are we going to leave behind? Praise God. Are we going to leave behind some believers, disciples, or are we just going to leave behind a bunch of junk for them to fight over to sell? See, that's the problem with the world today. They have more thoughts about items and merchandise and material things instead of spiritual things like God, our Lord Jesus Christ. See, I'm getting ready to go home. Amen. And any moment, every day that I wake up, I thank God. Because I know the next moment could be my last. And see, that's the way my state of mind is. I don't pick and choose who to preach to. See, God points the direction. That's where I go. Praise God. So, brothers and sisters, let's listen to another testimony from Brother Boyd. Amen. He called in about 39 minutes ago. And see what our brother over in Idaho, remember to pray for him and his sister and his mother. You know, he mentions it several times and when he calls in about his father, his dad being with the Lord and the sickness and the depressions and, the battle he had. And see, my friends, we need to be praying for this brother that when he overcomes all the situation, that he'll just raise his hands and praise God. So, brothers and sisters, let's listen to this testimony from Brother Boyd.
Hello, Brother Willie. I love you, and I'm praying for you. God bless you. This is Brother Boyd Glendon in Idaho. I've got a Bible here open to Ephesians chapter 4 to Ephesians chapter 5. I just wanted to encourage people that Jesus wants us to live differently and to get that sin out of our life. Listen to this, but you've not so learned Christ if indeed you've heard him and have been taught by him as the truth is in Jesus, that you put off concerning your former conduct the old man which goes corrupt according to the deceitful lust and be renewed in the spirit of your mind. So you were supposed to put off that old man that grows corrupt according to those lusts. We're supposed to be born again and changed. And in Galatians chapter 5, it talks about walking according to the spirit and according to the flesh. We're supposed to put to death the fornication, sexual immorality, impurity, lust, drug use, drunkenness, all those sins, homosexuality, lying, cursing, cheating, foul language, filthy language, all those sins. You can read that in Galatians chapter 5, Colossians chapter 3, here in Ephesians chapter 5. We've got to put off that old lustful, corrupt self. I was controlled by pornography, lust, anger, cursing, and so many sins. Lived in all those sins, had a foul, filthy mouth. Such a fool for the sins that I lived in, but I confess Jesus was Lord. I was baptized in the lake, and Jesus helped me get those sins out of my life. But I know many people that are watching pornography, living with their boyfriends and girlfriends before marriage is called fornication, living in homosexuality and all kinds of sins like that. And they say they believe in the Lord from John 3:16, and even say they're going to heaven, but Jesus wants us to put off that old self and that sinful nature. This is Ephesians 5:1, walk in love. Therefore, be imitators of God as your children and walk in love as Christ also has loved us and given himself pour us an offering and sacrifice to God for a sweet-smelling aroma. But fornication, all uncleanness or covetous, let it not even be named among you as is fitting for the saints. See, it's not even supposed to be named among us. We're supposed to put off that old self and get rid of the sin. Jesus said, repent or perish, repent or perish. And there's neither filthiness nor foolish talk, nor coarse jesting, which is not fitting, but rather the giving of thanks. For this you can know, that no fornicator, unclean person, nor covetous man who is an adulterer has any inheritance in the kingdom of Christ and God. Let no one deceive you with empty words, for because of such things the wrath of God comes upon the sons of disobedience. And if we're living in these sins, fornication, these sins, we will not inherit the kingdom of God. You can read at the ending of Revelation, the impure, the sexually immoral, all liars, the people living in sin can't go through the gates into the city, into the new Jerusalem. And you won't go where Jesus is unless you can truly repent and start saying no to the sin. Father, right now I want to come to you and pray in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Please help us to say no to sin. Help us to say no to fornication, no to the sins. Give us the power to change and say no to sins. Please forgive all our iniquities, heal all of our diseases, and redeem our life from destruction from Psalm 103. Please help us to say no to the sin. The people living in the fortifications and sin, help us to say no. We can do it, Father. Help us to put on the new self. Help us to say no to sin. And I pray this prayer in the name of your Son, Jesus. God bless all.
Barney.
Catching Babe Ruth, catching Roger Maris, the way you caught my eye in Paris, Tennessee. Settling seduction, I'm seduced. We sell a war, then we sell a truce. Ain't it the truth? Baby, just close your eyes. Nothing catches Jesus by surprise. Funny how things change. We're amazed how they stay the same. Baby, just close your eyes. Nothing catches Jesus by surprise. About trouble we've had our share, and it's a wonder we're still here. I don't know why I make you cry. It's a part of me I don't like. Just close your eyes. Nothing catches Jesus by surprise.
Amen. See, there's nothing that catches Jesus on surprise. Amen. See, the Lord knows the troubles you're having today. Amen. He knows the troubles that is at your door. But you know, there's something you can do. That's right. That's right. You can do. You could pray. See, the power of prayer is more powerful than any gun, any nuclear bomb, anything that you see of this world that can cause destruction. See, our Lord Jesus Christ didn't come to destroy, but to bring life. And that's why the House of Prayer Radio Ministry, moi, Evangelist Willie here, is to bring life to you, that you could die where you can live for eternity. And that's the biggest problem with the world today. Everybody wants to have religion, but they don't want to have God. And don't get me wrong, now a lot of people say they love God and they say they do things for God. But if you look at the fruit and how they live and how they treat each other, you don't see much God in them, do you? See, my friends, that's why here at the House of Prayer that we're trying to grow this ministry that the Lord has given us to let you, amen, let you, the listeners, if you have a song or a testimony that you would like to be played on the ministry here, hey, hit me up at 207 Southwest, Scottsville, Kentucky, at the House of Prayer Radio Ministry. Send us your CD, send us your links, or hey, we even getting set up that for too long, we're going to be having, we're going to be calling and chitter-chattering with the other brothers and sisters and see if they would like to Skype or the website called Hangout, and we're going to interview them. Amen. Let God be God. You know, so many times that the church door open, they'll open the scriptures and they'll read it, and then they'll ask for prayer and then they go home. See, my friends, we got to walk through faith. Amen. Not by sight or things we know of. We got to walk by faith. See, every day I walk by faith because that's all, basically all I've got is faith. Because there's a lot of times in my life I don't know what I'm going to do and when I'm going to do it, but I know God knows where I'm going. So, praise God. Let's remember to pray for Bishop Eddie Chaney and the Sons of Thunder down there. Praise God. Friday at 7 o'clock. You can hit him up on Bishop Eddie Chaney. There's more information. There's some cell phone numbers that you can call. Let's see if I can pull it up here. Yeah, here we go. If you'd like to get some more information, the 14th, starting Saturday, the 14th. We said Friday, but I don't know. Oh, well. But if you'd like to get some more information, call 606-910-4310. 4320, my bad, 4320. And, hey, you can get Brother Eddie or Donnie Sloan, Brother Donnie Sloan down there, and they'll lead you right in there. I wish I could go, but I got a prior engagement, praise God, that I got to go to Indiana. I got to go bless a house, praise God, and talk to somebody about a son down there that has tried to commit suicide. And he's asked me to come down there, so Friday, we're going to be leaving early. And me and my wife and my daughter, we're going to go bless the house, and then we're going to pray for that son. Amen. That's our job as the body of Christ, is to pray for the other ones. Amen. That God will be God in their life. See, God didn't make us to destroy ourselves. He made us to grow, to learn, and to be able to praise and worship God and our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. So, my friends and family, pray for me for safe journeys down there to Indiana. Praise God. That I'll be doing the Father's will. And that me and my family will be safe going there and coming back. And let's remember Brother Corbin Chaney. Praise God. He had asked me to come down there for a tent revival last week, and I couldn't be able to make it because I had a prior engagement. See, my Lord tells me, go where the people are hurting. Amen. And looks like Bishop Eddie Chaney, he's doing a fine job down there, because I've heard a lot of good report, praise God. And souls are getting saved, lives getting changed, and it sounds like you're getting the socks blessed. Amen. So, brother and sister, let's remember Bishop Eddie Chaney and his family and his beautiful wife, Sister Pauline, and all that family. Amen. Let's remember to pray for one another, that when a time of troubles and heartaches and broken lives, that God will step in the scene. Praise God that when we're down and out, that God will lift us up. It says in the Word that He draws all men nigh to Him if we lift Him up. So, my friends, lift Jesus Christ up today and let God be God. Amen. So, brothers and sisters, we're going to play this song here, and then we're going to break into the Word. Praise God. And today, like I said, we must die to live. Amen. So, brothers and sisters, enjoy this song, When the Angels Cry.
They came from near, they came from far, following a distant star to where He lay. Not being sure of what it meant, but knowing it was heaven sent, they made their way. And the creatures gathered round and didn't make a sound, and the angels cried.
The angels knew what was to come, the reason God had sent His Son from up above. It filled their hearts with joy to see, and knowing of His destiny, came tears of love. And the creatures gathered round, didn't make a sound, and the angels cried.
About that night, and wondered if they realized that star so bright
was sent to tell all the land the Son of God would soon become the Son of Man.
And the creatures gathered round and didn't make a sound, and the angels cried, and the angels cried, and the angels cried.
Amen. Amen. Praise God. You know, sometimes the angels cry when we fall. Praise God. But you know, one day, the body of Christ will not have to hear the angels cry no more. Amen. See, when Jesus Christ comes back, for the ones that are true, that's been faithful, that has not lived a life of strife, wrath, anger, or resentment, or jealousy, the ones that are on that battlefield every day, praise God, that wants to serve God and obey God. But you know, there's a lot of people today that will not obey God, because they want to build something up for themselves. They want a legacy. See, the only legacy I want, my friends, is the Lord's legacy. The Word of God tells us that we must be born again. Praise God, that we must stay true to the very end. Amen. See, somebody leaves this earth every day. Now, can I tell you if they're going to heaven or hell? No. See, we make that choice. We can live for God and obey God and do His commandments. Or we can die not knowing God and go to hell. See, the choice is yours. See, God don't send people to hell. They send themselves there. They make a choice every day of your life. Is this of God or is this of me? See, that's what we need to ask ourselves every day. So, brothers and sisters, right now we're going to go to prayer, praise God, and then we're going to see what the Lord have to say. Amen? Amen. So, everybody that's listening in the morning, the evening, or on a CD or on archive, let's go to prayer. Lord, Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for another day, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for the blessings that you've already given, the ones that are coming, Lord. We ask you, mighty God, that all the evangelists, the bishops, the teachers, the preachers, the elders, all that's in your will, Lord, we ask you to strengthen them and protect them with a hedge of protection, Lord. We ask you, mighty God, that you be in our hearts, our mind, and our spirit every second of every moment of our life, Lord. Lord, if there be any sick among them, let them be healed, Lord. We ask you, Lord, if there's a sin upon their life, we ask you to forgive them. Lord, we ask you, Jesus, to step up and be on the scene today as we bring the word, Lord, that your will be done in heaven and be on earth. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, we pray. Well, glory. Amen. So, brothers and sisters, today we're talking about you must die to live. Praise God. And today, there's so many people that wants to hold on to the flesh. Praise God. Instead of walking in the Spirit, they want to do what they want to do. They don't want to do what the Word of God says. Amen. So if you have your Bibles, let's look over here of a demonstration of what Jesus said you have to do. Praise God. You look over here in John 12, starting at the 23rd verse. Philip came and told Andrew, and again Andrew and Philip tells Jesus. And Jesus answered and said unto them, the hour is come that the Son of Man shall be glorified. Very, very, I say unto you, except a corn of wheat falls into the ground and dies, and abides alone. But if it dies, it brings forth much fruit. He that loves his life shall surely lose it. But he that hates his life is the... Let's get back here. My eyes went around on me. Lose his life. And he that hates his life in this world shall keep it for eternity life. Let's stop there for a moment. Praise God. See, you can love your life, but you can't be in love with your life. See, you got to be on that battlefield, my friend. You got to say, enough's enough. The sin must come to an end. It must die. See, the Lord Jesus was giving them a proverb there, my friend. He was telling them, you must die. And he was using an example of a kernel of wheat that once it dies in the ground, it brings much fruit. See, my friends, today you, that's right, you're that kernel of wheat. You got to put it in the ground and let it die where it can grow fruit. See, my friends, we must be born again. You can't just say, well, I got saved when I was 20 years old, and I'm good, and I'm once saved, always saved, and I'm going to heaven. Let me tell you something. That is a lie from the pits of hell. Repent, or you will die. You will perish. My friends, today you need to understand that God has a plan for you. Amen. He wants to bring life, and he wants to bring it more abundantly to you. He wants you to stand up and proclaim the word of God while you're still breathing, my friend. Don't let people know you by a tombstone, but let them know that you were a man and a woman of God, that you stood up for the truth and the righteousness of our Lord Jesus Christ. Praise God. All right, let's continue on here. Praise God. 26 verse here says, if any man serve me, let him follow me. Where I am, thou shalt also my servants be. If any man serve me, him will my Father honor. See, now, There's a promise right there that Jesus gives, that if we follow him, we be faithful, we be true, that he will honor us. I don't know about you, I don't care to have honors of men, but I want my honor of my Father. That he's proud enough that he has chosen me to sanctify me, to purify me in the blood of Jesus Christ, that I could be able to be honored in his kingdom. Do you want to be honored by Jesus Christ today? See, my friend, you got to learn to die to live. See, you got to give up the old ghost of the old spirit that you came into this world, praise God, as a sinner. See, we're in training ground right now, my friend. We're training to be saints by our Lord Jesus Christ. But so many people wants to be purdy saints. Amen. They want to be known for the purtiness, their houses, their churches, their building. See, all that stuff that you hold treasure to is going to burn. See, my friends, we're here at the House of Prayer Radio Ministry to tell you that you can change, but you must die where you can live. That's right. You got to die from the fleshy things of this world. You can't let people tell you how to live your life. You see, that's where we got to go in prayer. We got to get into that quiet place and talk to God. So, Lord, what do you want me to do? How do you want me to live? What do you want? I mean, we shouldn't be asking our pastors how to live. We should already know. We shouldn't have to go to a fancy church and have a bunch of people praying for us. They should be already be praying for you. See, we got to come together and unite ourselves in the Word of God. Now, I've tried to unite with other ministries. Amen. But it seems like too many of them wants to be a chief. Nobody wants to be an Indian. See, when I look in a ministry, I look for people that are treat each other as equal, not having a title or having an office and saying they got this kind of authority or that kind of authority. Or no, I don't look for that. See, there's only one authority that I hold treasure to, and that's Jesus Christ's authority. Because he's the one who gives the blessings, and he's the one who gives the curses. See, we got to understand today, praise God, that if you want to be honored, you better honor our Father. You better honor Jesus, and you better, amen, you better honor the Holy Ghost. Because you can cuss out God, and you can cuss out Jesus, but if you dare come against that Holy Ghost, woo-wee, my God, you better repent now. See, Jesus said, I think it was Paul, he says, brother, I wouldn't want to find you ignorant. See, that's the biggest problem with the world. They are ignorant in God because they think, well, God's just a loving God. He's just a merciful God. But, you know, you got to understand that God is a jealous God and a wrathful God, and he will not play kid games because he's a fair God. And see, we're all going to be measured for the things we do in this life. Praise God that we're going to have to answer for every deed, good, bad, or the ugly. Amen. So, my friends, my family out there today, if you're lost and undone, and you need a little touch from heaven, why don't you get on that old bended knee right now and say, Lord, forgive me. I'm not going to lead you in no prayer. I'm not going to say these words and you're saved. No, no, this journey you got to take with God. Now, I can pray for you. We can anoint you with oil, and we can pray all night long till you get your breakthrough. But see, you got to open that door. That's right. You got to open that door of your heart and let Jesus in. See, too many people try to make God hard to understand. It's simple. It's as simple as this. You accept him, you believe him, you obey his commandments, and then you'll be with him. See, my friends, you don't have to put on a big show. You don't have to travel 3,000 miles to preach the gospel. See, there's people in your own neighborhoods right now that needs to hear the word. And they need to hear it till they come to re-understanding, or they get burnt with a hot poker and left for damnation and go to hell. I mean, no, it's the truth. Praise God. See, God will point out to you who you both to preach to, who you both to go to. But you know, I've got so many friends and family right now that they'll go 5 hours away from their home to preach the gospel when their own neighborhood needs God. It's true. Now, don't sit there and say, well, my neighborhood's good. We're all safe. No, if there's somebody starving in your neighborhood, or somebody's running around naked, somebody's cussing and beating on their wife, or having the sexual morals with their kids, let me tell you something. That person's not saved. See, Lord is coming back, my friends. You need to obey God before it's too late. And now, it's like I say every service, when God's done, I'm done. I don't get on here. I ain't got the gift of chitter chatter. God tells me what to say, and then I roll to the next thing. Amen. So my friends, my family, remember me in prayer. If you would like to Skype, amen, or hang out, hit me up on Facebook. We'll work out the details that you can come in and let's talk about Jesus. Amen. And tell the world what God has brought you through and what you're willing to do for Jesus. Amen. See, now it ain't gonna be no Benny Hill deal or any of that Graham stuff. We're just going to be, as the body of Christ, come together in one mind, one spirit. And we're going to talk about Jesus, because the Lord has showed me some visions that so many people is drawn far away and get going out and listen to somebody tickle their ears. We're not here to tickle your ears. We're here to preach the gospel that your soul will be saved. Amen. So my friends, my family, I love y'all. Remember to call 270-681-8098. I'd love to hear from you. If you like to email me, you can email me at brothergrizzle76@gmail.com. And if you like to hit me up on Facebook, Evangelist Willie Grizzle, Scottsville, Kentucky. Amen. I would love to hear from you. So I love you guys. Remember, keep on praying, because God's listening. Amen. Love you guys. God bless.
There's nothing worth more that could ever come close. Nothing can compare. You're our living hope. Your presence, Lord. And I've tasted and seen of the sweetest of loves, where my heart becomes free and my shame is undone. In your presence, Lord. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come fly and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your presence, Lord. Your presence, Lord. Nothing can compare. You're our living hope. Your presence, Lord. tasted and seen of the sweetest of loves, where my heart becomes free and my shame is undone. In your presence, Lord, Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your presence, Lord. Oh. Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your presence, Lord.